talked about the lead problem, where there's, it's difficult to connect lead to account. That's what this L2A stands for at the top. But there is a lead to account Salesforce ABM trick that you can use to connect leads and accounts, and get value that way. So, the way that we do it is a domain field can link, can be sort of a common identifier between leads and accounts. And the way that we create this is we'll make a website. So we'll make the website fields, mandatory for all accounts. They have to have a website. And then basically always the lead's email address is going to have the same domain as the website domain. So in this case, you can basically say anybody with the same domain as the website is attached to that account. Using account scoring, you can avoid kind of like classic, I'm getting a little ahead of myself. Once you've got those things linked, you can then apply, let's say, the lead scores of each individual lead to an overall account score to evaluate what is the most active or engaged account that you have rather than doing it by lead. So allow me to illuminate like a pretty common lead scoring versus account scoring problem. So let's say that Bob's Battery Shop is an unqualified, too small account for you. And they have one person who fills out 10 forms. And let's say they get 20 points a form, so they get 200 points. They look like a very, very important, highly engaged, top-of-the-line lead, even though they're maybe not a very qualified account. Simultaneously, 10 different people from a buying committee at Microsoft all fill out a form. Now, ordinarily, this would be a huge positive indicator. However, they might each only get a score of 20, and your salespeople might not ever notice that anyone from Microsoft came in at all, let alone that 10 people all filled out a form at the same time. So in this case, if you're looking at the account level, you might be able to say, oh, wow, Microsoft as an account really just shot up in engagement. Having lead to account connection can really build this for you, and it's very, very powerful. Then you can sort of use whatever the lead activity was to guide how the accounts are doing. Well, now Microsoft is an informational account. Now the account is going through a buyer journey. So the way to do this is you first have to make sure that each account has an accurate value for website, for the website field in Salesforce, and that you do not allow duplicate websites. So like you can't have two different accounts with the same website. So this is sort of step one. This already requires a little bit of maintenance. Step two is then make sure that the lead object has a domain field. This is a formula field that pulls from the lead's email. So basically it just reduces whatever happens after the at symbol to just the domain. This is just a little bit of coding. It's not too bad to make that field. Then there is a fair amount more coding that has to happen. It can be done. We have this code internally. So for us at this point, it's much faster, but people can also be, obviously recode this. But the idea is then you're going to use use Apex coding in Salesforce to match the website value from the account to the domain value from the lead. And from there, you can pass data in between the account and lead objects. So being able to accrue an account score, set an account level buyer journey, stuff like that. Great stuff for ABM.